Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So yesterday we have learned about various data types and variable. So today we are going to learn something new which is called input command. Input command is very important and you all have to learn that input command so that you can take input from the customers, from the client. They will give the input and you can give them the output. So that's why we are writing a program so that all the customers can input into that. So this is a very simple, very short program that I'm going to write. Let's say I will give a new code here. This is a Google Colab, by the way. You can always open it by Python, Google Colab, and it will work as a Jupyter Notebook. You can use Jupyter Notebook as well. So here, let's say I will say name is equal to input. Input is a very important thing because it will take input from the customer. In the inverted commas, I'm saying enter your name. Okay, and then I'm giving one space so that he can give it in a proper way. Then I say age is equal to input. Then I will say in inverted comma, enter your age, space, enter. And then I want to print this. Without print, you will not get any output. So for print, I will say in inverted comma, hello, space, plus name plus. So hello, I am saying this is a string, basically hello. Hello will print at it as it is, and then there is a space and then the name. Whatever the user will input, it will take that name and then say in inverted comma, I will give one space. Then again, I will say plus how I want my result. See how I want my result. So I am saying your age is then a space, then plus, then age. So this is a very small program which you all have to, you know, write and run it. Then only you will understand that, okay, what are the things you can do in Python. So input is a very important command, guys, because you have to take input from the customer. Let's run that. So when you run this, it will first ask, enter your name. So I am saying Saurabh. What is your age? My age is 16. Simple. I am 16. Then I say enter. So he is saying, hello, Saurabh, your age is 16. So let's say, think about, shopping mall or, offices where people are entering. Just say hello to them. They will just enter their name and age. And this will give them in the return, hello, Saurabh, your age is 16. Or hello, Saurabh, I will say plus in inverted comma, welcome space. And then again, inverted comma. Let's run this program again. See what will happen. Run this program again. I say Harish, age is 15. So hello, welcome Harish, your age is 15. So if you get this kind of welcome in any shopping mall, in any area, you don't have to write again and again this program. So if you write this particular program in the backend, it will run. Okay, so this is the very simple thing. Let's say we are in India, especially in Kanpur, in my city. The people are very, very much, I will say, code new. They are very intelligent. And few people are very, great. So let's say run this particular program again. Let's say something called Raju, kind of person, enter into the shopping mall. And he said, enter your age. Let me give Pandit. Okay, then I enter this. So it is saying, hello, Raju, your age is Pandit. Why? Because whenever you are inputting anything into a variable, it will take it as a string. It will take it as a string. So that's why it is saying, like, if someone will give his age correctly, that will show. But if someone will give as Pandit also, it will show there as Pandit. So this you have to understand that how to make this program robust. You have written a program. It is running properly. That is fine. But how will you make it robust so that the people will not do any, will not create any problem into this particular program? And for that, what we will do, let's see here. I will copy the same program again. And now nobody will give anything else what I want. I will take the input, but I will take input only integer. That's it. Integer is what? A whole number. I will not take even decimals as well. So if I write here integer and open it and then close it here. Simple. Okay. Enter. And I'm saying make age as a string, because we are concatenating, and when you concatenate anything, you have to make it back to a string. Okay. So now if I run this program and someone will try to type any, you know, any letters, alphabets into the age column, it will give an error. Why? Because I have made it very clear. Let me make it bigger for you. So here I have made it very clear to it, but take integer as an input, nothing else. If you do not take integer as an input, it will give you an error. Let's run this program. I will say Rohit and age is 15. Hello, Rohit, your age is 15. Simple. Next, let's say I will say Virat, and then I will say age. I will say Kohli. Let's see what will happen. I have identified it as an integer and I'm giving here it as a string. Enter. See. So it is giving me an error. It is saying invalid literal for integer with the base 10 Kohli. So it is telling me that you have entered your age wrong, because it is asking for integer and you are giving it as Kohli, which is a string. So this is the problem here. Again, run this program. I will say Saurabh. I will say 15. It will run properly. Hello, Saurabh, your age is 15. One more thing we have to see. Let's say somebody, you know, some smart people of Kanpur will do like 15.5. And they say this is a float. They have to take that. Let's see what will happen if I give a float here. If I run this program again and I say Saurabh and I say 15.5, let's see what will happen. So again, it is giving us error. Why? Because we are asking for integer and you are giving it as a float. So guys, writing a program is a different thing, and writing a robust program so that nobody will do any changes into that. That is very important. So you have to learn this. So I'm asking the age into integer and then I'm converting into the string so that I can print it here. But people are giving like, you know, 15.5. 15.5, it will not take. It will take only if I make it float here. Then it will take the decimal values as well. So make the program robust. You have to run it in several ways and you have to think logically that, okay, what all inputs can customer give? So here I will give Ravi Shastri, age is 59, and see, it is working fine. If you give in decimal, it will not work. If you give in alphabets, that also it will not work. So guys, this is the small input program that you have to learn, because see, these are very basic things which I am telling you here. But when you reach to a next level, when you will do any logistic regression or any other thing or any other demand forecasting, there you have to do all these things in the small, small chunks. Then only you will remember this. Okay, you have to give input only in integer, otherwise it will be a problem. What is the string? How can I type a string? How can I concatenate the string? When you are giving any value to the variable in an input format, it will go in a string base only. That's why I'm converting the age again to a string and then I'm pasting it here in the concatenate format. So guys, I hope you like this video. Write a program to enter your name, your age, your college, whatever biggest program you can write, and then ask someone to print that. So it will print like a paragraph kind of thing that, hello, Mr. X, you are from Kanpur and your age is 47. You have done BSc in mathematics. So something like that. Take an input from the customer and print a paragraph for him. Try that. Put that in a comment box. I will want to see that, okay, what code you have written there. So guys, and make it robust so that nobody will give, age as XYZ. They have to give age in integer only. They have to give address in the alphabetical format, make it a string. So these things you have to take care. See, nobody can teach you everything, but I am teaching you from the scratch so that you can learn and you can write your own codes, own programs. I hope you like this particular video. Please share and subscribe with them. Share with them who actually want to learn Python, who want to write these codes in the Python. So I'm using, Google Colab. You can use Jupyter Notebook, anything you want, and you can do that. So input command is a very common and very important command when you work in a real project. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good day. Thank you.